The good part for LeBron is you're playing with a lot of guys who are basically where Kyrie Irving was.
Yeah.
So you can help them become fully realized individuals, which is why I personally would not be shocked if LeBron won MVP. I'm taking the Lakers to win 52 games this year. I think that Lonzo is going to be an all-star. I think LeBron will be an all-star, and I think Brandon Ingram will be an all-star level talent, but he won't make it. Lonzo was damn near all-star last year. All voted. Now you put LeBron in this city. Lonzo still got his own show. All Lonzo has to do is literally show up. Don't do anything stupid. I need 16, 10, 8, 2, and 1 from Lonzo. That's what he can give me.
I mean, yeah, but even if he gives you 15, 8, and 8, planning.
15, 8, and 8, it's not going to get him in the All-Star.
Yes, it will.
No, it won't.
15, 8, and 8?
No. Guys like Draymond, because Lonzo not going to start, so that means he got to outplay guys like Draymond and Clay and Wiggins.
Look, it's fan voting, bro. It's fan voting. Starters are fan voting.
Yeah, the starters. He's not going to get voted. He got to go against James Harden, Steph Curry, Russell Westbrook.
Steph could start. Steph going to start. The others, I don't know, man.
It's not happening.
I literally don't know.
It's not happening.
Lonzo
would have to come out and play like a superstar.
A superstar
in year two.
The man was sixth in voting amongst guards last year. He was sixth. Amongst voting guards last year. Now you put LeBron on this team another year. I'm assuming he comes back improved. It's not inconceivable to think the fans may very well vote this man. Yeah, but like second in voting. Obviously, Steph's gonna get the most voting because it's Steph. After that, it's not inconceivable to think he was sixth last year. Might have been fifth, actually. I think it was fifth or sixth. He had more votes than Dame did. It's not inconceivable to think that this man may get the second most votes amongst guards. He could dead ass start. It could happen. Now, it's a long shot, but it could really happen. You talking about you playing in LA. If he come out and give you, like I said, 15, 8, and 8, that means in some game, that means probably he going to have about 4, 5, 6 triple-doubles by that point. And I'm saying, you already playing with Bron. You're going to get televised every single day.
Oh, I can't wait.
You're going to get put on so television many every TV. Single day. You play 82 games. 45 of them gonna be on national television.
But it's also up to Lonzo. Lonzo got to play like an all-star.
He got to play hard.
But all right, to wrap up LeBron. I'm sorry. To wrap up King Watch. I'm sorry. I got to get used to it. To wrap up King Watch, aka LA Bron Watch. I got one final quick question. Looking at the free agent market. Not a ton of crazy talent left. We saw IT go to Orlando basically. Yeah. Aaron Gordon re-signed in Orlando. Boogie is with the Warriors. Avery Bradley re-signed the Clippers for 2 years.
Tyreek is with the Pacers now.
Yeah, Tyreek is with the Pacers. The Lakers have Lance, JaVale. Randall is with the Pelicans as well as
that
Rondo.
That was like surprised at Randall's deal, by the way. I thought he'd get more.
Yeah, which is why if I'm him, I'm really confused by his method of operation. And my only reason why I'm confused that it is because of the fact that if the Lakers would have offered you a 1-1, which, because I'm sure that's what they wanted, because of the fact, which is what he got in, for New Orleans, to come play with LeBron, and my only thing would be, I guess it depends on if they told him if he would be starting or not. And I think that the Lakers starting lineup next year is going to be Lonzo Ball, Kentavious Caldwell-Pope, Brandon Ingram, LeBron James. Actually, I think it's going to be Lonzo Ball, Brandon Ingram at the 2, LeBron at the 3, Kuzma at the 4, and whoever at the 5.
Jesus Christ, do you know what the junior high
role and my reason, and my reason, and my reason for starting Ingram over KCP is, as well as Kuzma at the power four over KCP, because KCP naturally is the fit to start a shooting guard, and he might go on to start a shooting guard. Reason why I start Ingram is because immediately your backcourt has nothing but length, right?
Doing this, you covered up the whole court.
And the other thing that Kuzma forces the other team's power forward to do is now you have to account for Lonzo Ball, Brandon Ingram, LeBron, and Kyle Kuzma. Kuzma gave you 16.4 last year, or 16 plus last year, off the bench, essentially.
And I know
put him with LeBron. You know he been in the gym working. His big thing is he don't even want to be traded. Because he's like, I don't want to go to San Antonio. I want to stay here and play with Lonzo and Bron. His motivation is, if Kawhi don't come, everybody going to be looking at us like, yo, y'all the reason y'all why.
So why
the same reason why he said, yo, I'm a Laker now. I'm going to show y'all why I belong. Yeah, and he did. So if you start Kuzma at the four, that LeBron gets his stretch four. But he also gets a stretch four that has a killer instinct like Kobe, that can take you off the dribble, that can dunk on you, it has vision. And last year he averaged 4 assists, I believe. He can get that number up to 6 or 7, which then makes him effective. And then you put Brandon Ingram out there. When you want to sub in lineups, you either run lineups with Rondo, Ingram, LeBron, Kuzma, KCP. Or you can run in KCP. That's your small ball lineup. Or you can run Lonzo, KCP, Ingram, Kuzma, LeBron is your small ball lineup. Or you can run Brandon Ingram at the point guard, Lonzo at the 2, KCP at the 3, Kuzma at the 4, LeBron at the 5.
It's like, I don't think
like
people,
you get so many like, different lineup combinations.
I really
you can
don't
do
think
that.
People understand like what you said. Like, for me, it's not the offense. Forget the offense. Offense gonna be there. I'm talking about the defensive versatility.
If they
you have.
I think the Lakers will be not only a top 5 team on defense this year, but I think that what we saw, and the other thing about it, LeBron is coming from the worst defensive team in the NBA to a top 10 defensive
team.
But
if you peep in the playoffs, they were much better. In the playoffs,
take away the playoffs.
Terrible.
Still,
look, I think honestly,
and you don't have IT on your team anymore, so you don't even have. The Lakers have no
weak link.
Well, only the weakest link they have is at the center position. But really, if you run a small ball lineup,
they're not even out there in
the Lakers' version of a death lineup in 3 years is going to be as potent as the Warriors is if these guys achieve their potential.
I agree.
But we still 3 years away from it. So we need LeBron to be LeBron.
Years, honestly. I think it depends
on Ingram, though. Ingram is the joker in this entire deck.
I agree.
Like, he could be anything, but he could also be a deuce of clubs.
Yeah.
So it's like, hey, but go ahead, get your final thoughts off. Who do you think are the free agents that they're going, that the Lakers might sign to help the King on his watch?
I mean, I even saw Amir Johnson's name floating out there. I wouldn't like.
I'm not mad at that anymore. I was earlier.
Yeah,
before Boogie and Randle were off the market. Now I'm not mad at that.
I'm not mad at Amir. I just think for the Lakers, you need help at center. Obviously, Dwight's gone.
You wouldn't have wanted him.
He wouldn't have came back anyway. But I mean, still, just name. Yeah.
He ended up in a good spot though. I think that would be Nash and Shaq and Shaq's and Nash's last year.
I think Dwight.
But he got Wall.
Yeah.
Beal.
I think they have a chance to be a top 4 seed in the.
I'm not angry.
But Amir, I don't know what other centers. I would have loved to see Noel there. I think that would have been dope for him. But he's in.
Yeah.
OKC
the problem
now.
Is he wouldn't have started on this team, so it's kind of
like,
ain't
starting OKC.
Yeah, but he wouldn't have started on this team, and then it kind of, and then you got a bunch of guys that are like in between power forward, small forward thing. And if he can't shoot,
center.
But if he can't shoot, you can't leave him on the floor when teams go small.
You can because his defensive versatility is
but
so great.
He can't
great.
Shoot.
Doesn't matter. His defensive
versatility
can't
shoot.
Is so great.
He can't shoot. The Lakers don't have. The Lakers are already the biggest problem that the Lakers, which is also the free agent I want them to go and get is Bielitsa. Bielitsa, I think the Timberwolves renounces his rights.
Yeah.
He's a guy last year
where
he can shoot, but he wasn't even playing that much, and he's still young. Go get him, bring him off the bench, let him turn into your Kyle Korver-esque shooter where you bring him in the game for stretches and run him out there with LeBron. And you saw how many open threes he got last year with Wiggins and Jimmy. The problem was that he wasn't getting none of them in rhythm because nobody on the team could shoot. So he the only one taking threes, him and Crawford. And also, I wouldn't mind if they went and got Jamal Crawford for the bench, and I wouldn't mind if they went and got Bielitsa.
I don't know if there's room for, like, where is he going to play?
You're not going to play him that much. I mean, you're not going to pay him that much.
But where is he going to play? And I think Crawford still wants to, if I'm Jamal, I still feel like I can play.
He can play.
But where are you going to play on this roster? Like, who are you going to, like, they have a lot of guards already.
But Josh Hart is in year two. The point is, we were talking early in the show about building out this team. And having this and this potentially being one of the best teams LeBron has been around, all around team. A guy like Jamal Crawford is a guy you need on an all around team.